Sunset by Rod Lewis. Read by Steve Parker.
I know why you did it.
Ray stared out of the bedroom window, watching the sun slowly disappear behind the distant hills. A gentle breeze lapped at the curtains and caressed his face soothingly. It was a perfect evening. I knew you would come, he replied. He reached for his walking stick and slowly turned to his companion. I've missed you. Welcome home.
This isn't my home anymore, Ray, you know that.
The voice was soft like the breeze, no hint of malice. Ray sighed and shook his head.
You always did state the obvious, Philip. I've missed that, too.
He hobbled over to the watching figure, the arthritic pain disappearing at the pleasure of seeing Philip again. Philip extended his arms, and the two embraced affectionately.
Why did you leave me?
Ray whispered, not wanting to release his grip.
I had to go. You know that.
Ray inhaled deeply and stepped back.
You look good, he offered.
Younger. You always look younger somehow.
I feel younger,
Philip responded, warming to the compliment.
I'm still 65, but I feel much younger. I've never been happier.
The words stung Ray, and tears welled up in his eyes.
Never, he asked. No.
Philip's response was as tender as his smile.
You know I can't lie to you. I never could.
Then perhaps it's for the best that you left me.
Don't be sad.
Philip took Ray's arm and led him to the cane chair in the corner.
It's going to be a beautiful sunset tonight. Sit here and enjoy it.
Remember.
I remember.
Suddenly, it hurt too much to look at Philip directly. Ray gazed out the window from his seat.
I remember everything. I remember too much. All the good times and the bad. But most of all, I remember the morning I woke up alone. I wish I could have told you I was going.
Together forever. That's what you promised. I thought I was enough for you. Enough to make you want to keep that promise. But I wasn't. I wasn't enough.
Nothing lasts forever, Ray. We had 40 good years together. I was getting old. We both were.
I still am. Ray's temper surged unexpectedly.
But you, look at you. You look 10, 20 years younger.
Philip chuckled.
You're exaggerating. No one can get younger, not even if we try.
Are you happy? Ray asked, changing the subject.
Really happy. As happy as I could ever want to be.
Are you lonely? Philip paused, considering his answer.
Not like you, my friend. Never like you.
Tell me what it's like, where you are. Did you go far away? Escape from me to the furthest reaches of the earth? Philip sat on the floor by Ray's feet, leaning his head on Ray's knee.
You already know the answer to that. I could never go far, and there was nothing to escape from. If you ever really needed me, I would have been here.
Like now. Like now. They sat in silence for a moment, the first shades of pink beginning to paint the sky, wrapping itself around the fading yellow glow just as Ray and Philip once had to each other as young lovers. They had met in high school, bonding instantly and becoming the best of friends. At university, they had remained inseparable pals, and in their first years in the workforce, they had become lovers, meeting secretly each evening to talk, make love, and just be with each other. Ray remembered their first time. Back then, homosexuality had been illegal, and the butterflies that had run so rampant through his stomach almost forced him to turn around and run right back home. He smiled at the thought of it, and of Philip's careful first caress. When they had discovered each other to be gay, Philip had confessed to his brief liaisons with other men while Ray was still virginal. He had relied entirely on Philip to teach him all he now knew. 40 years. It was a long time to be with the same man, yet it passed in the blink of an eye. He remembered the sensation of Philip's skin pressing against his own the first time they made love. Philip was rakish back then, his sinewy frame devoid of any fat, while Ray was slightly heavier, with enough meat on his bones to keep both of them warm at night. The memory of Philip's body pressing down against his own made him breathless once again, his wandering mind transporting him back to relive every exquisite sense. The smell of Philip's breath as they kissed, the touch of moist flesh as his hands explored the contours of Philip's body, the taste of semen in the moments before they climaxed. The recollections grew, becoming more vivid with each passing image. The overwhelming marvel of Philip's touch, the unbearable euphoria of being so close to one so dear, the blinding explosion of his first induced ejaculation. He never truly understood what Philip saw in him, but accepted his love gratefully and returned it in abundance. "I'll tell you what I saw," Philip said, raising his head to look deeply into Ray's eyes. Ray started, not realizing that he'd been speaking his thoughts aloud. "I saw a beautiful, loving man who was my equal in compassion, in strength, and in intelligence. I saw everything that I ever wanted in a lover, and I saw, in my own reflection, the luckiest man alive." "I was the lucky one," Ray replied, stroking Philip's thinning head of hair. "You took me to heights that I never knew existed. Do you remember the time," Philip said, suddenly sitting upright, "that we went camping? We were in our late 20s, and we hiked down to the gorge by Waterfall Gully."
"That's right," Ray laughed.
"We got caught with our pants down by the ranger."
Philip laughed enthusiastically.
"I thought we were going to be arrested. After all these years, I still can't believe how impeccable his timing was.
I had my mouth wrapped firmly around your cock, and you were groaning and moaning and carrying on like nobody's business.
And just as I came, he stuck his head through the tent flap and copped it right in the eye."
The two cackled heartily, recalling the moment until their laughter subsided into silence once more.
"The sun is almost down now,"
Philip sighed, looking out of the window at the rainbow of colors now blossoming through the clouds. "You still haven't answered my question," Ray said. "Have you missed me?" Philip knelt up to take Ray's hand in his face.
"With every pore of my being," he said, "I've missed you each and every day and throughout every night."
The tears trickled down Ray's cheek, and Philip leaned over, gently kissing them away.
"I'm here for you, Ray," he whispered. "You don't ever have to be alone again."
"You'll take me with you," Ray pleaded.
"How could I not? It'll be just like old times, only better. Open spaces, no more hiding. Just you and me and our love forever and ever."
"You've said that to me before," Ray countered.
"How do I know you won't leave me again?" "Because this time there's no reason."
Ray thought about Philip's answer. The last rays of light were almost gone now as the night slowly edged its way through the window. A single candle on the table beside him flickered anxiously, spilling its ever-strengthening glow over their faces.
"It's almost time," Philip said. "Come, let me help you to bed."
He lifted Ray from the seat.
"It's 1 year to the day, you know," Ray asked him.
"I know," Philip said.
1 year tonight."
"I'm scared."
"Don't be. Look."
He pointed to the bed where Ray's slumbering figure lay quietly, the empty bottle of sleeping pills still clasped in his hand.
"No more pain. No more tears. Just us."
"Did it hurt when you left?" Ray asked.
"No, I didn't feel a thing. Just your skin on my lips as I kissed you goodbye."
"I felt it,"
he whispered in awe.
"I felt your kiss. I remember it."
Philip smiled knowingly and lay Ray down on the bed.
"Oh, blow out your candle," he said, barely audible. "The light is going out now. It's nightfall. Time to rest. Time to be by my side."
And the curtains fluttered as the candle flickered out.